I bring you greetings from here. On today's video, I want to talk about the reasons why it is very difficult for Africa to unite. I have made a video about this particular topic on Facebook. It was live. But it's unfortunate that some part of the video was removed by Facebook, as they have relentlessly keep fighting any truth coming from Africa. So I choose to record this video and upload it on my YouTube channel. I will as well share it on my Facebook page and my wall. Many of us that are familiar with the history of African colonization, talking about the reasons why it is difficult for Africa to unite. If you know the history of when Africa was shared as a meal on a dinner table in Berlin, Germany, it was that day that the Portuguese had their own share. The Chinese has their own share. The French had their own share. The English had their own share. The Arabs had their own share. That was the day the creation of the difficulty in African unity began. I am going to dissect this point that I just made. It is difficult for Africa to unite because, one, Africa was divided with different languages. Two, Africa was divided with different currencies. Three, Africa was divided with artificial boundaries. We all know that all of these people that had their share on the day Africa was served as a meal on a dinner table in Germany, they are speaking different languages. They are using different currencies. And it came to Africa during colonization. They all came with their different languages, with their different currencies, and also divided Africa and created artificial boundaries just out of their selfish and greed and devilish interest they has in Africa. You all know that as the Portugal, all the countries that was colonized by Portugal today are speaking Portuguese. All the countries that was colonized by France are today speaking French. All the countries that was colonized by Britain are today speaking English. All the countries that was colonized by Arabs are today speaking Arabic language. So on and so forth. That is one of the problems, because it is really possible for people that speaks different languages to come back and come together as one and share things in common. That is the tragedy that happened in Africa during colonization. And you all know that all these different countries, different nations that took part or that had their shares when Africa was shared in Germany for colonization, they also uses different currencies, as they are also using different languages. And during colonization, they influenced all the countries that they colonized with their languages and currencies, like you can see it today. ranging from Senegal to Mali to Burkina Faso to Cotonou. I'm talking about, especially in West Africa, they are using France currency, which is CFA. Looking at Nigeria today, being colonized by Britain, they are using Naira. I know it was created, as well as the name Nigeria was created by Britain. Looking at country like Gambia, they are using Dalasi, different currency. Looking at Sierra Leone, they are using Leon, different currency. Looking at Uganda, they are using shilling, different currency. Looking at Libya, they are using dinars. Looking at Ghana, they are using cedis. Looking at Seychelles, they are using rupees, so on and so forth. So how possible is it for countries that uses different currencies to trade in one market without conflict and without differences? That is the tragedy that happened in Africa during colonization, that lead to the current problems we are facing today with disunity in Africa. I'm talking about the artificial boundaries. Only in West Africa, you can believe with me that we have over 30 boundaries that was created by the colonial masters during the era of colonialism, so that they can have their way, so that they can create these differences and have their way. Only in West Africa, if you take a journey from Nigeria, even a journey that can even be embarked on with jogging or trekking, just from Nigeria, crossing to Lomé, crossing to Cotonou, to Mali, to Burkina Faso, to Senegal, to Gambia, you will count how many boundaries that you will cross. They did this in order to instigate these differences, in order to make us believe that we are not the same people, in order to see ourselves as different people. That was one of the reasons all these artificial boundaries was created. You have seen the tragedy I'm talking about. That is why it is very difficult for people that speaks different language, that uses different currency, that has been divided with different artificial boundaries. That is why it is very difficult today for Africa unity to be achieved. There is only one way out of this. Like I said, that I will state the solution to this problem. The only way out to this is to make sure that the dream of Kwame Nkrumah comes to existence, which is for Africa to have one currency. Also, like Gaddafi, it was also the dream of Gaddafi for Africa to have one currency. This alone will deal with the differences in currency in Africa and therefore attract unity. Another way to deal with this is to also bring forth the dream of Haile Selassie of Ethiopia, that Africa should have one nationality and one army. Apart from having one nationality and one army, that Africa should also have one language. If Africa should have one common language, it will go a long way to deal with these language differences and disunity in Africa, and therefore bring forth unity. in Africa. By having one nationality, Africa have been able to deal with the artificial boundaries we have, because we would therefore see ourselves as one. It is simple. But I urge the leaders of Africa to rise up to their feet. To rise up to their feet and unite Africa with one currency, with one language, with one nationality. This is the only way out of this problem. This is the only way out of this disunity in Africa. Do well to subscribe to my YouTube channel and other platform that I use to disseminate my message, because Facebook never relent from frustrating the efforts I am making personally, and other freedom fighters in Africa are making, by removing our videos and cutting up our videos and messages and pictures on Facebook. Thank you and God bless you.